Blackstone Publishing presents The Other Side of War with the Army of the Potomac by Katharine Prescott Wormeley. This book is read by Kate Mulligan. Prefatory note: Military Order of the Loyal Legion of the United States, Commandery of the State of Massachusetts. Most of the writings relating to the War of the Rebellion have been confined to accounts of battles or to adventures so closely connected with the battles as to seem an essential part of the conflict itself. The book here given to the public as The Other Side of War touches on matters almost entirely outside the noise and smoke, the glory and pomp of military operations. Yet it presents scenes so intimately related to the Army that they seem an essential part of a soldier's experience. The general work of the Sanitary Commission has been fully set forth in histories and in its own invaluable papers and reports. This more personal record of its earlier labors tells a story not elsewhere told of how it began, and under what circumstances it first carried on its heroic work. As such, these remembrances of the Hospital Transport Service are presented by the Commandery of the State of Massachusetts of the Military Order of the Loyal Legion of the United States to its companions as a portion of its contribution to the history of those eventful days, and in grateful acknowledgement of the loyalty and devotion of those men and women whose fortitude and grace have given to the Sanitary Commission its honored place in the story of the great conflict. Arnold A. Rand, William P. Shreve, Henry Stone, Committee on Library. Introduction. The United States Sanitary Commission was an organization of private gentlemen whose voluntary and unpaid services were accepted by government at the beginning of the War of the Rebellion to supply the deficiencies of the medical department of the Army. It was the outgrowth of a demand made by the women of the country. For in the Great Uprising, nothing was more marked than that the principle which actuated the nation was shared alike by men and women. As the men mustered for the battlefield, so the women mustered in churches, schoolhouses, and parlors, working before they well knew at what to work, and calling everywhere for instruction. What were they to make? Where were they to send? The busy hands went on, but where was the work to go? Some supplied regiments with articles that were practically useless. Others sent to various points on suggestions afterwards shown to be untrustworthy. Little circles and associations of women were multiplying, like rings in the water, over the face of the whole country, but they were all in need of guidance and of information, and they felt it. Time and the Sanitary Commission were to show them that by a great united effort, their work was to broaden out into a fundamental good to the whole army, that lives were to be saved, the vital force protected, and that women, guided by the wisdom of men, were to bear no small part in helping to maintain the efficiency of the troops, and thus to share upon the field itself the work of husbands and brothers. At a meeting of women informally called in New York, April 25, 1861, the providential idea of attempting to organize the whole benevolence of the women of the country into a general and central association ripened into a plan and took shape in an appeal addressed to the women of New York and others already engaged in preparing against the time of wounds and sickness in the army. This met with such an answer as showed the deep felt need of it, and thus began the Women's Central Relief Association in New York. But still, the need of instruction and the futility of trying to carry on the association without better knowledge of the work to be done pressed anxiously on the minds of its members. At this juncture, the Reverend Dr. Bellows came forward with sound advice to make inquiry.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.